problem is all inside your head, she said to me. The answer is easy if you take it logically.
Hey guys, Mike Keller. I'd like to say I'm thoroughly motivated to make some more prints. I'm trying to get there, but not quite yet. There's a little bit of this mindset to getting going in the darkroom. You probably know that already. I stumbled into this little image. I had been missing the negative. I don't know what happened to it. It was in with some color slides. So I really wanted to print this. It's a sweeper cleaning up outside the state capitol early one morning. And I really wanted to print this, so I went in the darkroom and I was half set up. And I had an old bottle of developer. And I used this old developer that was 2 months old sitting in the jar. This print's pretty decent. I'm happy with it, but I'm going to mix up some fresh developer and I'm going to reprint this print to the best of my ability, and then we'll look at the two of them side by side. So here's the negative for that image, and we'll see what a print looks like with fresh developer. So I'm shaking out this developer bottle here, and remember, you've got this area here that gets chemicals in it. So when you rinse your stuff out, you really want to make sure you're rinsing it out so you're draining whatever was up in the handle. Two test strips into this print, here's number three, and it dawned on me that no one being familiar with how much a stop is in lighting is pretty important to this, because the first test strip was, my guess was 12 seconds, two stops down, it was too light, so I went up a half a stop, which is half of what the time is or half of what the aperture is. So I could have opened it up on the lens a half a stop, or I could have added a half stop of time, and at 12 seconds, half of 12 is 6, I would add 6 seconds. So my second exposure was 18 seconds, and that wasn't enough, so I added a full stop. I changed the time from 18 seconds to 36 seconds, and this is where I'm at, adding a stop. So it's important in photography to get the feeling of what a stop is. You might do some tests with some exposures you're making, make them a difference of a stop, print them out, 1, 2, 3 stops, look at them all side by side, get a feeling for how much brightness one stop is. So when you look at a test strip here, you can go, yeah, this needs about another half stop. So if I was going to add a half stop to 8 to 36 seconds, half of 36 is 18, so I would be adding another 18 seconds on to 36. 54 seconds would be the exposure. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to add about 4 more seconds and see how this looks. We'll burn a real piece of paper here. Be careful not to get my palm in the developer, because I jammed it with a screwdriver yesterday. Well, I'm through 20 seconds. Might be a lot. I don't know. Only way to find out is to go the standard time that you develop your prints for and see what it looks like there. 1:40 is pretty good for me. We're coming through 1 minute. Print's gonna be ready, song's gonna be over. Everything's gonna happen all at once. This is on a very low contrast. This is on a 1.5 contrast. But it'd be hard to tell until it's dry. I might want it on a 2. Here's the other one at a 2 contrast. And we're 20 seconds into this guy. We used to overdevelop our negatives a lot at the newspaper. It's just a fact of shooting a lot of stuff on one roll of film. And of course the solution is to print lower contrast. If you get the balance right, it's a good range of tones. But if it's a really bright scene, it's hard. Why are we here? Coming through 1 minute. Number 2 contrast. Number 1.5 contrast. What it does is it darkens up the branches on the tree here, and it makes that area look darker. That area of the print. That's what it does for me anyway. Gotta see them dry. I don't know. But now, the first one's ready to move over into the second fix. I've got one issue with this print, and it's this right-hand side, right where the wall is above, behind the car. I don't like the crop there, that dark area. I really want to see if I have a little bit more of that in the negative. I think I do. And move over a little bit more to the right. So we are looking at the area right along the side here. Fairly noticeable. I move the blade. There's significantly more area there. I was cropped in like that with that little tiny area, so I really want to be more over to the right. And I've got quite a bit more to go, but I can't just move that easel. Blade, I need to move the whole easel over. Some things you just can't do one-handed. All right, so here's the reprint. There's the first one, that area above the car. There's the reprint. And it just makes a difference. It just contains that space. If anything, that upper right-hand corner in here, I'm going to go back and burn that in a little bit. But for the most part, we're in pretty good shape. Maybe burn in just a hair. Take a little bit of that bright glow out of there and bring up the fender on the car. So you think you're done, but no, you're not done. I'm not done. So I'm going to go back and I'm going to burn that upper right-hand corner in. I'm going to give that about a little bit less than a half a stop, maybe a quarter of a stop. So that would be a quarter of 40 seconds. I'll give that about 10 seconds up here in this corner. Oops. Zero. I believe in superstition. I believe when you look at the clock and it's just coming through zero, that's a good sign. Unless something bad's happening, then it's a terrible sign. Alright, so I'm going to move this second one over here into the fixture. Test strip. Rinsing my hands in between everything. Alright, so a minute. I can take this. Warm it up a little bit, help the development out a little bit there. Where are we here? Through a minute and a half. That's the door's plan. Yeah, see that upper right-hand corner now, compared to before? Just a little bit darker. Run up the car a little bit. That yellow dot is a safe light. All right, this is it. Absolutely, that was the last one of this. We'll dry them all, and we'll look at them later. Okay, so I've got these on the screen. I got a couple of them flattened already, and we'll compare them. I cheated. I put these two in the press for 45 seconds, and then I put them right out under the glass. And if you look at that bottom edge on this one, you can see the ripples in it. It needs that extra 30 seconds. There, you can see it pretty good there. It needs that extra 30 seconds of drying. And I'm not convinced that these didn't dry real fast. 25% humidity down here in the basement. And I left these on the screen overnight. So once again, this goes back to the idea that you need to take them off the screen soon, not let them get too dry, and put them in the press. Now, they can't be wet, but they're not totally dry. They may have just a little slight tackiness to them. But anyway, this needs to go back in the press. Okay, so here's what we got. Five prints, always have to make one more. So we can eliminate immediately the two where the crop on the side was too tight. That's these two. Gotta see what we like best out of these three. I'm looking here at the contrast. I'm looking at the building upper right, and I'm looking at the brightness on the street on the right side. same thing here. Upper right of the two. A little bit more on the right-hand one, a little bit more in the street on the right-hand one. The streets just looks kind of bright to me. A little lighter in the upper right there, a little brighter on the street, maybe too bright. I'm comparing upper right sides here now. One of my, on the left is a little bit darker, but I like the street better. The one on the right. A little bit better contrast on the car. I'm going with the image on the right. This one. Now, let's compare that to the original one. Top one is the original one, bottom one's the second one. And I'm liking the second one better. Again, I'm looking at that upper right-hand corner. I'm looking at the street. Kind of washed out here, but this is the whole point. We were using developer that was 2 months old to make this print. I was using developer 2 months old to make this print. And it suffers in the highlights. And I'm looking at the right-hand side, comparing the right-hand side here. I burned it in, I think, about the same on both of them. But even burning it in, it wouldn't make a difference like that. The one in my left hand here, this one here, is just crisper and sharper in the highlights. And that's your argument for not using old developer. There you go. All right, let's get on to the Indian stuff. The problem is all inside your head, she said to me.